Edith Cavell was a nurse who was executed at dawn in Brussels on the 12th of October 1915. In this short documentary, we will be looking a little closer into the reasons behind her fateful death. We interviewed some leading experts and recorded their answers to our questions. Let's look first a little at her background. Edith Cavell was born in December 1865, the same year as George V.
She was had quite an interesting upbringing, not just because she was a vicar's daughter, but because she grew up in the church and she was a daughter of the church, really. And so I think that shaped the kind of person that she was very definitely.
Edith Cavell was trained at the Royal London Hospital in Whitechapel. She worked in various hospitals in England, including the Shoreditch Infirmary. But what kind of woman was Edith Cavell?
She was a woman of courage and of strength and of conviction, of faith, and that was definitely rooted in her understanding of what it meant to do what is right in the world. So even her decision to become a nurse was very much a part of the compassion that she felt she should bring to the world.
And, you may know already, Edith Cavell loved dogs. In 1907, Cavell was recruited by Dr. Anton Depage to be matron of a newly established nursing school in Brussels.
She went to Belgium to found the first secular training school for nurses. It was a huge achievement, because nursing had just been done by unqualified nuns and religion and helping people without any particular expertise were how it was all done. And she did actually build from scratch this revolutionary nursing school.
So, why did she decide to return to Brussels at such a dangerous time?
I think she would have felt personally responsible for the nurses that she was training in her nurse training school, the Birkendale Institute. Some were, for example, from Germany, and so it was important to send them home. You had other nurses from France, you had nurses from Britain, nurses from lots of different countries who all needed to be given advice. In some cases, very young nurses. There was one who was even her personal ward. So, you know, she was in loco parentis in charge of that particular nurse. So it was very important for her to return, and she would have felt a personal sense of responsibility for the nurses that she was training.
This terrible time when Germany walked into Belgium and war happened, she became a subversive. She lied to the authorities, she concealed evidence, she didn't do as she was told, she wouldn't register.
Could she have been a spy?
Her prime intention was to get wounded Allied soldiers and lost Allied soldiers to freedom. But there were also the war guides who did have letters that were to do with resistance information. She was involved heavily in an organized resistance movement. But I don't think that's quite the same as her being an active spy.
She was arrested on the 3rd of August 1915 for harboring Allied soldiers. The penalty, according to German military law, was death.
The priest of the Anglican Church where she worshipped in Brussels came to give her communion. And he said to her, remember you as a heroine and a martyr. And she said, don't think of me like that, think of me as a nurse. Tried to do her duty.
People are tempted to want to call her a sort of a martyr, that is, she was killed because of her Christian faith. That's really not quite accurate. She was executed because she was guilty of treason, and she knew what she was doing, and she knew the consequences.
What effect did Edith's death have on the war?
And it was used for propaganda purposes. I mean, you know, "Avenge Edith Cavell" was a recruiting slogan. The Germans were portrayed as evil Huns who would murder a slayer nurse. And in Germany as well, people were horrified. I mean, worldwide, there was great horror that they treated her like that. So it didn't do them any good. There was some argument that it brought America closer into involvement in the war as well.
When the First World War finished in 1918, her body was disinterred, and in early 1919, her body was brought back to Norwich.
What is Edith Cavell's legacy?
A legacy of bravery in the face of adversity, of nurses putting the safety and care of their patients before all else, and really the importance of active military nursing in the field.
I have no fear nor shrinking. I have seen death so often that it is not strange or fearful to me. Life has always been hurried and full of difficulty. This time of rest has been a great mercy. Everyone here has been very kind. This, I would say, standing as I do in front of God and eternity, I realize that patriotism is not enough. I must have no hatred or bitterness towards anyone.